Ticket number 17, another very important product from Microsoft, which is called Microsoft Teams. Now, you already worked on Outlook, which you know it's really important for email. So people are using Outlook for communication between staff members and also external clients or whatever it is. They use email communication with everybody. But when it comes to Teams, usually most of the companies, they use Teams type of product to communicate with each other through chat, voice, or screen recordings or screencasting, or let's say webcams. They do meetings, everything on Teams. This is equivalent to, let's say, using a Zoom or some other product, which is very important for companies. So you need to understand that any company that you go to, and this is a corporate level company, businesses, they're going to have to talk to each other some way in a very efficient way. So one that if you understand and learn more about Teams, then people will already know that you can learn anything else that they have. And Teams is very, very famous in many, many companies. They use it. So we have Amy in this ticket, which is we have recently transitioned into Office 365. You have been doing this for the past few tickets now. And I'm in need of assistance to set up Teams for my machine. And I would like to test Teams with Adam to explore its features for future use. So as an IT support professional, do you really need to know about Teams at the very advanced level? Not at all. Actually, they hire people just to manage Teams, meaning they have actually positions to actually just do the Teams job. So again, this is another part for some people that if you love seeing this type of stuff, then maybe that is something you want to get into in more detail than make a career out of it. So you just need to know how to work with Teams, configure it, troubleshoot it, and of course you need to know more than just a normal user, but you don't need to really know and extremely going to go crazy on it as an IT support professional to know every single thing about Teams. You may not even have a lot of access to configure such things. So do keep that in your mind and don't get stressed if you see more and more products now and you're just thinking, am I really need to learn all of these things? So remember, just configuration, knowing how to troubleshoot it, and also a little bit of basics will help you because people will ask you questions. And if you know more, that's good, but just don't go crazy on it. All right, so let's go to Amy's machine and set up Teams for her. And then we will set up Teams for Adam. And then they both will connect with each other, chat with each other to see if Teams is working in this company. So let's go ahead and connect to Amy's machine first. And if you look into this, Teams usually doesn't come with Office 365 installation. It actually comes directly with operating system. So I'm going to show you which one comes like normally when you have a Windows 11 operating system, you're going to see something like this. So if you search for Microsoft Teams, it will show up. If you have a home account, then you can just log in directly and you can use Teams. But in most of the companies, they use companies, Teams. So here's, it says get Microsoft Teams for work or school. So you need to click on it and this will take you to a link to download Teams for work or school. Okay. It's different. So if you go online and just type Microsoft Teams download, it's going to take you to the same link. So you need to scroll down and here it says Teams for work or school. So we're going to click on download the new app. So we're going to say keep. Once you keep it, go ahead and run this application. And then it says install Teams. We're going to go ahead and click on install. Okay, so once installation is almost over, you're going to see some more configuration options popping up. Just give it some time. So you should see this box. If it doesn't show, then go ahead and search for Microsoft Teams and open the Microsoft Teams new app. It should show up in your search. So let's go ahead and sign in now with an account that we have created for Amy. If you remember, you did this part in the early tickets. You know the Amy account and the password. If you don't know, you have to go back to your portal.office.com, check Amy's account and reset the password if you forgot when you created it. So it should look like this, and we're going to go ahead and click next here and then type the password. And we're going to say okay to this message. So again, this is going to do the same thing. It will register this device to your company, whatever system they use, and I'll show you that later on. So every time you register a device with a company, they have a cloud portal where they just see, okay, which machine have been registered with us through this application. So now you see now it's done. And just like OneDrive, Outlook, things are so easy now. You can just open it, use the username and password, the email and password, and then you are inside the application. So now the team will open up, and this leads you to Teams. Like I said, after that, it's up to the company. They do their own trainings, by the way. You know, most of the time, their HR people or communication people, they do all these trainings, and you should go and attend these trainings to make sure you learn how they use certain products in the company, because this is a user product. It's not something that a very IT product that you're going to use to do some sort of troubleshooting. You're going to still use Teams for communications and even for troubleshooting purposes, but it's an overall product for everybody. So people will call you, I want Teams on my mobile app. So maybe in your mobile, just download an application, use the same username and password, and open a mobile app on Teams, OneDrive, things like that. As long as you know you don't want to mess up your own systems, always use some sort of alternative mobile devices. So let's open this, and now Amy is inside Teams. Okay, so what's next? Most of the time, maybe if they want you to show them the setting area, like I want to change my certain setting like status and things like that, you can come here, tell Amy, yeah, this is where you can change the status here. You can sign up from here. You can click on these three dots. It gives you settings options. So a lot of time people say, I can see small things, big. I want a bigger text, so you can change things right here. If you come to the setting area, this is where most of the settings from Teams will show up. Again, the information, how you're getting all these settings and information for sharing and privacy, most of these things can be controlled from the backend, which is the administrator of Teams can make sure that what type of access they want to give users. Just like you have the control over a whole Office 365, you can do a lot of things. You can remove application from somebody's access and things like that. That's how Teams have also, even Teams have their administrator, so they can pick and choose stuff over here, which we will cover some of it later on, because maybe you may be working in a company where you do have to do this sort of stuff. So we will do some basics on this area, like how do you go into the administrative side of specific applications and then give people access and permissions and things like that. So most of these calls are going to be related to this, where people are going to come and say, I want my camera is not working. So you go to the devices, you do a test calling, you add a camera, you test it, because we don't have any cameras here. So cameras will show up, and that's where you just kind of like do those basic stuff for a lot of users. They don't know how to add their cameras or like microphones and, you know, stuff like that. And some people may have questions about privacies and things like that. So you may just want to come over here and play around and look into these things a little bit more in detail. Go online and find more about Teams. But the most highly used is going to be the chat area. This is why Amy called us, right? So Amy's right here. And then Amy's saying that I want to chat and test with Adam. So I'm going to go ahead and click on new chat here. And then I'm in a new chat right now. So this way, Amy can look for users over here and kind of find Adam and then chat with him. But at this point, we haven't set up Adam yet. So we do need to go to Adam's machine now, do the same process on Adam's machine, install Teams, and then start chatting with Amy, and then so we can close this ticket. So let's go to Adam's machine and do it. So we'll keep this tab open. Let's go ahead and move to the new tab. And here, go to desktop, and let's go and do the same process. I'm actually not going to record this whole process. And I'm just going to go to Adam's machine and log in as Adam, download Teams, log in as Adam, and just exactly what I did for Amy's. And then once everything is set up, I'm just going to start recording that. So we have installed Teams on Adam's machine. So let's go ahead and search for Teams. It should automatically open but you can also search for it. Just like that, there's this one right here, the one that says Microsoft Teams Work or School. So I'm going to sign in with Adam account. You already added this in the Office 365 when you did the early tickets. So you know the username and password. So go ahead and type Adam email and the password here. If you don't remember the password, go back to your portal and reset the password because you created this account. So let's go ahead and click Next. And let's log in with Adam. There you go. We're going to click OK here. Done with Adam. So on one machine, we have Adam. On another machine, we have Amy right here. So let's log into Amy's machine and Adam is right here. So we can create a chat between these two, test it. And then, of course, it's more tips I'm going to share with you. So let's go ahead and get started here and cancel this. And let's log into Amy's machine now because she did ask us to test between these two, right? So here Amy is like own self, right? So if you want to test it, you're just going to click on this new chat here, and here we are going to type the name of that person that you would like to chat. So we're going to type Adam, and you see it went out there and looked for Adam, because that's how most of your company members are going to be already there, and you're going to look for them and they'll find it. Even your team members might be using a Teams tool for you to collaborate. And that could be a Teams right here. So usually it's not going to be like one-on-one chat. People have Teams, IT support, marketing, stuff like that. So it's going to be a big thing in your company, and they will do a little bit of orientation with you how to do things, okay? So here, if I am in the chat right now, I can just type hi here. And let's go back to Adam's machine. And let's see if we received, there you go, we just received hi here. So the status shows that both are online, and here from here on, they can do more depending on what they want to achieve from their conversation. So if it's sharing a document, they can share a document from here. If it's something like, you know, more stuff like, let's say scheduling a meeting. So your Outlook and Teams and everything is now connected. Even your OneDrive is connected over here. And of course, Microsoft Office is bigger than that. So OneDrive is used for personal, but then there are the other SharePoint type of things. Like there are more company-wide document sharing can be done in Teams and stuff like that. So it's a pretty big thing in this area. That's why people offer a full-time jobs just to do Teams stuff. So if you can do everything like this and you love this, get into it, learn extensively, and then just go and apply to these type of jobs, and then those could be really cool jobs for you, and it's really web-based, remote, and things like that. But it's way bigger than just chatting right here. So in most companies, what they will use something like this, and they'll say, oh, you know what, you're having this issue, you're there too. It's like, okay, how about we just talk to each other, because I think it's better to explain it on the audio call. So you're just going to click here and start Amy audio call with Amy. So when you click on it, depending on if you have a microphone and cameras and things like that set up on that system, then it's going to go out and start calling Amy. So here you go. It started calling Amy. You can come back over here and Amy should be getting a call right here. So they see something like this. Adam is calling. So we're going to go ahead and accept it. So then they both are in this call now. So in the team meetings, or like, let's say if it's like 30 people, you're going to see 30 cameras, people will be right here, like it's going to say 40, 30, 100 people like joining in this area. And then you're going to be joining those team. And then, of course, depending on what do you want to do with this person now, talking to them, chatting with them, sharing application, you can do that. But most cases, they share cameras, they talk to each other, and then they share screen sometime, which is a big one. So even for IT support, you could use Team, but Team has its own limitation when it comes to real support, like installation, troubleshooting. It could have those type of limitations in there. So, but for a lot of time, we do use Team sometimes to just help people out on basic stuff. So if Amy wanted to show something on the Word, with Adam or she wanted to do something more extensive like trainings with them, she will just need to say, okay, let me share my screen with you, Adam, and that's how I'm going to share you my stuff so you can learn from me. So Amy will say, okay, you know, let's go ahead, let me share my screen with you. So she click on share here, and then she can start sharing her screen. So here Amy can pick a screen, different type of screens, sounds and stuff like that, all that stuff that Amy have available here, so she can do that. So now Amy can pick screen 1, 2, and then basically once she pick it, you see how she picked it and she starts sharing the screen. Now, if I go back to Adam's machine, what will happen is that Adam is going to see Amy's screen right there. There you go. So now Amy can show Adam what she wants to show, but Adam can also take a control of the presentation if let's say he requests it. So these are the things that you're going to come across from users. They will call you, hey, I'm trying to share my screen. How can I make it full screen? How can I move it out of this whole window? How can I chat at the same time? My voice is not working. My camera is not working. A lot of tickets will just generate from Teams for you. Just so think about this. You are the IT professional. So just sit with yourself and ask yourself some questions and say, okay, if people are using this type of applications, what can I expect? So the best thing you can do is to learn more about Teams like an administrator. Just go and learn more about Teams, how people are learning about it. So this way you will realize that this is the type of questions, this is the type of tools or cameras or audio or stuff like that. I need to work on it. So then, of course, you're going to get a really good confidence when you're coming across any type of product like Teams, Zoom, or there are many other products. And if you come across that, you already know because you worked on something really cool product like Team right here. So this is how Amy and Adam have already tested your ticket and everything is good to go. They're happy with you. You've done your job. Go ahead and close the whole ticket and then you can finish this. But for your project, what you need to do here, you need to come to the admin's machine, making sure that you have shared your screen from Amy's machine just like this. Because when we see your screenshot, we should see Adam's machine and Amy on top right here. It says Amy on top, and then and the screen is shared with Adam. So we would like to see that in the screenshot to give you the grade. So Amy is sharing her screen with Adam. Your screenshot should be coming from Adam's machine by showing Amy right here. So if I click screenshot, take a screenshot, there you go. It should say Adam A. And we will see Amy in there, Amy sharing her screen, and that will let us know that you have done the whole thing, and now you know exactly how Teams works.